Woo!
Come on, Josh.
I guess now that we know a little bit too much about that guy's balls, we're all more comfortable to talk about each other. They actually asked us to do a second round, round two. This is a competition. It's a default by death. We're going to do competition until two of the three comedians die. And that's actually the winner. It's not about being funny. It's about who lives the longest. The next person coming up is going to be an audience member. We're not going to tell you which one it is. We're going to choose which one it is.
Uh-huh.
Y'all paid for a show. Y'all are getting it. I'm talking about jobs here for a second. I've had a lot of weird jobs. Pawn shop. Pawn shop was a fun job. They used to pay me to clean the trash room. They used to pay me to clean the room they threw their trash in. So I'd clean the room and say, yo, I'm done. And then they'd throw more trash in. And then I'd have to clean it the next day, and then throw more trash in. These guys saved everything, too. Like, they gave me, like, a stack of 12 VCRs, and I said, Josh, I want you to test all 12 of these VCRs and stack the ones that work in a pile. So I have to have, like, two working, and I don't even remember my number, so 10 that don't work. And I'm going to throw these in the trash. I'm like, no, don't throw these in the trash. Just go throw it in the room. I'm cleaning that room. I'm going to clean the room, so I'm gonna end up throwing the shit away anyways. Yeah, they weren't really good at cleanliness. One of my jobs was a casino. I was a valet parker. I was a bellhop, and then I was a pool boy. I had three jobs. Everybody else had one. I had three. It was real fun, though. It was real fun. A lot of hostility. In the beginning of the thing, I kind of meet everybody, and we were just going down the line of all our heritage. Everybody was Indian there except me. So everybody's going around, oh, I'm a Cherokee, oh, I'm Redskin, oh, I'm related to Pocahontas, and it gets filled in, and damn, they come to me, and I'm just like, I could have been related to the Pilgrims, guys, I don't even know. That's when it got awkward. Like, they were just looking for a reason to fire me after that. Like, fucking Pilgrims, we don't like you guys. I know, right? You know what's weird about me? I have a Facebook, and I have a Twitter, and I have an Instagram, and a Snapchat, and I have all this shit, but I have the same 10 friends on all of them. Like, there's no need for me to post a picture on Instagram, and then just connect it to Twitter, and then connect it to Facebook, and then I might as well just Snapchat, but there's no need to do any of that, because the same 10 people who like my picture on Instagram like my picture on Facebook, and then his favorite on Twitter. Like, it's the same 10 people. It's the same thing with phone. Like, I don't need texting. I never text anybody but, like, three people. Two of them are family. My friend called me a couple days ago. He never called me. I was like, I don't fucking call people. I don't need a phone. My mom threatens to take the phone away all the time. Like, Josh, if you don't behave, I'm gonna take your phone away.
Please! I don't ever fucking use it!
I don't know, man. It's crazy out there. You know what I realize about relationships these days? My friends always told me about, at least with my age, it's always a competition, it seemed like. The girl doesn't text you back for 20 minutes, so you don't text her back for 25. I have a friend who wouldn't text his girlfriend back for 4 fucking hours. And I'm like, why didn't you do that? Well, she didn't text back for 2. It's like, it doesn't fucking matter. Just fucking text and be twice as easy. Nah, they just give up. I didn't realize how big of a competition it was, though, until I had a girlfriend. Yeah, one. I recently had her. Yeah, shut the fuck up. I'm a good guy, guys. Yeah, I'm a good guy. Anyways, this girl, I realized the competition started real early because I'd go hang out with friends and she'd show up and I was like, what are you doing here? Well, you were here, so I'm here. And I was like, yeah, but I didn't fucking invite you. I was like, well, if you go out, I go out. I was like, well, I guess that fucking works like that. Then she started flirting with people. If she saw me flirt with a girl, she'd go flirt with a friend. And not just any friend. Like, the girl, like, the guys I hated, she'd go flirt with them. So we weren't dating at the time, and I flirt with a waitress. They're paid to flirt with you, so I'm not, you know, I'm gonna flirt that back, obviously. It's, you know, it helps the self-confidence. So this girl, like, flirts with my friends, and then I go flirt with a girl, and she go flirt with a guy, and just go back and forth. And then we start getting, you know, we start having sex. And then, like, you got to where sex was a competition. Who was better? Obviously, you know, I'm a guy, so I didn't last long. She won that fucking competition. Yeah. It really, it ended with her winning completely because, this is back, when I got to watch a movie, and she was going out of town for a week, the next day, and she's like, Josh, if you stay, we'll have sex. I was like, oh, really? So I had sex with her, you know, and then I left, you know, to go watch a movie, and I'm like, oh, I fucking beat her this time, you can't beat me now. I went back at her house around 3 a.m., and she had sex with my friend.
Aww.
She won. She won all the fucking way. It's weird now. Now I see, like, I think I won, though, because I seen her new boyfriend. And as you notice, like, I'm wearing a flannel. Like, I always have flannels on. And I have these glasses. I always wear glasses. I have this fucking beard right here. I always have this beard. I invented the bum look, motherfuckers. This is my look. Her new boyfriend used to be country. 2 weeks later, he's wearing a flannel and a beard like me. I won the competition, man. Didn't I? You want me back? Yeah, she's a sweetheart. Not. Fucking bitch. Ugh. My friend a couple days ago, he called me and he got a new Mustang for his 21st birthday. Just fucking crazy. Fucking hate kids to get that shit. I've never been the type to get Mustangs or Corvettes or anything nice. I'll just say anything fucking nice. My 18th birthday, I moved out and my mom dropped me off where I was going. And instead of giving me a birthday gift, she asked for gas money. Really? So I gave her $100. I mean, I guess, you know, that's my birthday gift. I gave her money for my birthday. That was always fun. My 19th birthday party, I had a surprise birthday party at IHOP. People aren't good at surprise parties anymore, because, like, the 9 people that were going, each individually told me it was a surprise birthday party. Like, all on their own, didn't know that the other guys told me, Josh, I have a surprise birthday party at IHOP. Well, the other 8 fucking people that are going to be there already told me, so I know. I'm surprised. We're going to ruin it. I'm turning 21 this year, and again, it's going to be another shitty fucking birthday, because I'm here all alone, like I just moved. Now, you know, you're 21st, you should have your boys with you, you should be drinking, you should be, you know, strip clubs and shit like that. Now I'm going to spend it with my mom. I spent Halloween with my mom, that's the fucking boringest thing ever. We watched Ghost Avengers, and I fucking passed out candy for half an hour until I gave the kid the home their box, basically. Fucking sucks. Like I said, rehab with my mom, guys. Don't ever go to rehab with your mom. Don't ever go to rehab. Don't quit shit. Drink. Smoke. Enjoy life. I'm 20 and I'm saying that shit, so you know I'm. Ugh, fuck. It sucks, doesn't it? Let me think. I have to see that. I'm completely running off my brain right now. I'm just spitfiring this shit. That's what happened. It's not funny. It's not funny. Stop laughing. It's not funny. You're gonna have a lot of fucking problems, bro. It's messing. You're funny, man. Other than your balls, Joe. That was kind of weird. I know what I'm gonna get this guy for Christmas. A fucking cat. I might take you to a Chinese restaurant if we can eat a little. Yeah, right there. Goodness. You know, I read online that this place like awards prizes, and not a lot of money, but you get money. I have a job now, motherfucker. Nah, seriously, I'm unemployed right now. I'm unemployed. It is hard to get a fucking job right here. I moved from a town of like 10,000 people, everybody competing for the same job, so it was easy to get there because it was such a small town. All you can be is funny or good looking, and the job's yours. And that's how small of a fucking town it is. But you got Cove and Fort Hood and Killeen and Harper Heights, and all of them have like 20,000 fucking people there. You're basically. You're basically competing with all these fucking people for one job. And jobs here take like special requirements. I was on Indeed.com, which is a job searching place a couple days ago, and I found a janitor job. Required high school diploma, 2 years of experience, and 6 months of college experience. Who the fuck goes to college and says I'm gonna be a janitor? I tried to get a job at the Walmart here because I've worked at Walmart before. I ended up getting fired from the last Walmart I worked from because they have a rule, and it's called the 10-foot rule. And if you see a customer within 10 feet of you, you have to say, hey. And me being just a fucking talkable kid, you know, fucking shit. So I'd wait till they were 15 feet away. Hey, what's up, I'm in Walmart. I used to do it so much that I got fired for it. Like, you're doing the rule correctly, but you're not working at it. I'm just following the fucking rules, yeah, that's not right. I tried to get a job at this Walmart down here. Dude, they got rude. They got rude, man. I picked up the phone, I called them. The first lady answers, like, what's your want? Yeah, my name's Josh Oldo, I'm checking up on an application. Like, oh yeah, you are? Well, yeah, I'm checking up on the application. Who do you want to talk to? I guess HR would be fine, I guess that or a manager. After like calling 6 days straight, by the way, I didn't get a manager or HR for 6 days straight, they wouldn't connect with me. I finally talked to a manager, and the manager was like, well, I don't really want to say this, but I'm just going to say it, that stop calling. I was like, yeah, okay, I understand that, but I need a job, and this is the part of the job where you look for the job, you ask for the job. I'm trying to, like, get a job, but it does no good. I was like, so how do I get a job there? Well, if we need you, we'll call you. I was like, well, that doesn't work. Like, I need a job. I need it. Ugh, Walmart's hard to get onto, dude, man. That's easy. I'm employed right now, guys. I'm happy. My friends are going to finally call me and be like, hey, you finally got a job? Hell yeah, I got a job. I get paid to make people laugh. Shit, I've been doing that since I came out of my mom's vagina.
Oh my god.
Now I get paid for it. I would have started a long fucking time ago if I knew you could get paid for laughing and getting people to laugh. That's just, holy shit, I've been doing this so long. Someone told me it was during an English task, one that's worth 50% of my grade. My teacher pulls me to the side and says, Josh, come look at this. At first, you know, I'm just like, am I in trouble or what's the fucking deal? Well, this test is worth 50% of my grade, so I kind of need to pass it. Fuck that, dude. Who cares? I'll fucking get over here. At like 16 and 17, my teacher pulls up this guy named a comedian. He's like, you can get paid for making people laugh. I'm like, shit, really? I get wrote up in high school all the time for making people laugh. I can fucking do this all the time. Dude, high school is fun. Man. High school is really fun. I kind of graduated stupid though. Like, I don't have a lot of specialities. I really don't know how to do. Like, see, I can't even say a fucking word right? When it comes to math, guys, I was in a math class, and I was so good at basic math and algebra math that my teacher pulled me aside and said, yo, I kind of need you to teach the Algebra 1 kids. I said, okay, fine, I'll do that. I get an A anyways. I fucking teach them. I'm good at math. But I don't know anything above the Algebra 1. So I don't know any math, basically, at all. And nothing's useful. When it comes to science, I don't know anything about science because me and my teacher used to flirt back and forth. And there was no chance of hell of me getting my teacher, by the way. Like, there was nothing like that. She was drop-dead sexy. But she liked me flirting with her so much that she used to hand me tests, and I wouldn't know what the fuck I'm doing. I'm just like, I'm going to fail this shit. I write an answer, I hand it back. She'd erase my answers, write in the correct answer, and then give me an A. I used to get participation points in English class. I graduated school stupid. I have no idea anything. My sister came to me a couple days ago, and she's like, I don't know if I want to go to college. I'm like, Emmy, you're the smartest one out of me and you. Why wouldn't you want to go to college? I wish I could go to college if I wasn't so fucking stupid. I started college, actually, last year, and I went for a week and a half. That shit got hard, man. I didn't realize how stupid I was when I went to college. Like, that's when I created this joke. I went to college one day. I was like, you know what? I want to be a stand-up comedian. Why would I go to college? You don't need to go to fucking college for a stand-up comedian. Thank God for this job, right? No college experience. All you got to do is make people laugh. Fucking love this job. She's the best boss ever. I'm Josh Oldhead, everybody. Good night.